thank you for joining us on Data Cloud Now, where we bring you the latest in all things data in business and industry. I'm now joined by Sunny Bedi, CIO and CDO at Snowflake. Sunny, such a pleasure to have you back on the program today.
Thank you, Ryan. I love these conversations, so I appreciate you inviting me.
Top of mind for just about every executive right now is around Gen AI and LLMs. From your perspective as CIO and CDO, what are you noticing?
Well, look, every IT organization and data organization and security organization that I talk to, everybody is heavily investing in it, thinking through it, what should be the right governance around it, how should they go about doing it. And the overarching theme that I hear from every customer is you first need to invest in a data strategy. If you have a data strategy, it will translate into a seamless AI strategy. But if you don't have a data strategy, then the journey is even more complex. Fortunately for us as a company, you know, we're a data cloud platform company, and we've been investing in this journey for the last 10 years. And so our ability to transition into an AI strategy has been much better than what I hear from my peers, because we have always invested in AI, in data strategy, just like security. We think about data exactly like we think about security. We design from the beginning, not after the fact.
Sunny, I want to look inwards at Snowflake. How are you using Gen AI within the company, and how will it impact employees?
Yeah, so look, I think there are multiple use cases. I want to tease a few today. Let's start with the you know, employee experience. End of the day, productivity is the overall narrative that we're trying to go solve through AI. And as an IT leader in the company, I want to make sure that the employee experience is seamless. When we onboard employees, we give them a fantastic user experience. And it shouldn't stop there. It should continue to be the case as they get onboarded in their first month, the second month, the 6 months, the 1 year anniversary. And it needs to kind of evolve that user experience as they get onboarded with the company. And so what we're thinking is, wouldn't it be nice if we had an AI assistant that basically gets provisioned to you right from the get-go? You join the company, Ryan's first day, Ryan has an AI assistant working for him. And that basically is very much tailored for your persona of the type of work and the type of function that you provide for the company. And is self-trained with, you know, knowledge articles and other training curriculum that it would really help you, assist you to get onboarded faster and make you super productive. So you're not slacking 8 million people what you need, or you're not emailing your manager every fourth hour, like, hey, am I supposed to do this? And really have that experience across, you know, the entire community of employees that are onboarded and are going to join the company.
Great first use case, Sunny. But is there a use case that pertains to developers?
Yeah, that's definitely another use case that we're working on. Look, what happens in a software development lifecycle? There are three phases in every software development lifecycle. There is a design, there's a development, and then there's QA and test before we roll that automation or application into production. And let's just say roughly that all these three phases are broken into one-third, one-third, one-third time horizons that it takes to roll that out. Nobody likes to do testing and QA. Everybody likes to do design and development because they are more transformational. So our thought process is that, you know, we would again have an AI QA assistant that shadows the developer or the data scientist in the design and development and has the ability to train itself that we can significantly reduce and potentially eliminate QA and test because it's being done right from the beginning. Look, we have already done some level of POC work on this use case, and we're already seeing a 30%+ improvement where the amount of time that the developers are spending time on QA and testing, we can eliminate 30% of it.
Wow.
We think it could be much higher as we get this assistant a lot more matured and a lot more familiar with our environment. But imagine now I can get software developed 30% faster, put into production 30% faster, and give the benefit to the company, it's a significant productivity improvement for the company. And more importantly, it's really an up-leveling of the skill that the employees, now are not doing, they're doing more transformational work rather than, operational kind of work.
Driving impact along the way, exactly. Sonny. We've covered a lot, but is there a use case where you're putting all of the technology within Snowflake in the employees' hands?
Yeah. So I think the one use case, document AI, which was teased, at a lot of the Data World tours, is kind of captures all the new pieces that we are rolling into production. It covers Snowpark, it covers Streamlit, and it covers a lot of the LLM capabilities. And the use case over there is, imagine in our environment, we have 8,000 plus customers, and 8,000 plus customers have custom contracts on how we actually onboard each customer, right from the time a prospect gets converted into a customer, and how the customer then drives its maturity using Snowflake. There's renewals that happen, there's amendments that happen. All of those amendments and renewals that we do get captured in a PDF document. That PDF document is nothing but a DocuSign big document and captured in the PDF. It starts by a couple of hundred pages, but it can grow to become an 800 page contract.
And this is each contract.
Each contract. Now you times that with 8,000 plus customers and we're growing. You can imagine we have a massive unstructured data set in front of us that needs, decoding to be done. So what our engineers have done is an amazing capability leveraging LLMs is to feed all of these documents to Snowflake, apply LLM on it, and now I'm building a conversational AI agent leveraging Streamlit and basically doing very simple things like asking the app, tell me how many of my customers that I have in my environment have an SLA for some security breach clause that I have that requires a 24-hour notification or a 48-hour notification. In the past, if you had to ask that question, if the legal team had to ask that question, or our sales operations or security team had to ask that question, it's really going through these crazy amount of documents and basically looking for that clause that is clause number 35.
Very manual process.
Very manual and really like not real time giving the ability for people to ask that question and giving them the answer. Now imagine I have a Streamlit app. I am leveraging LLMs, I'm leveraging Snowpark and all the capabilities that we just announced today. And I'm basically just asking a simple question, and within seconds, you're getting that answer relayed back to you. And the most amazing thing is the app that we have written on Streamlit, you're literally typing a question in English. It's converting that into a SQL, and it's going and talking to Snowflake and giving you that answer back in a table format, in whatever format that you're interested in seeing that data. So it brings all of the capabilities together. And AI is going to be is going to benefit a lot from the unstructured data that's sitting in so many places that we haven't yet fully taken advantage of.
Sonny, always a pleasure sitting down with you. Thank you so much for joining me.
Thank you, Ryan. My pleasure is mine.
And for the audience watching, I'm Ryan Green with Data Cloud Now. I'll see you soon.